Here's an example of the problem. This is caused by the print head making contact with the paper during the printing process. The downward bend we discussed earlier is the first line of defense to the marks and smudging problem. Next, watch how your printer actually prints the cards. When printing the outside of your card, either the front or the back will come out first. You want to set your card layout so that the printer always prints the front of the card first. The front, or photo side of the card, is exposed to much more ink, so upward curling is much more likely. The trailing edge of the paper is free to move upwards and possibly strike the print head at the end of the print process. So we want to put as little ink as possible on the side that comes out last. Make a test print to see which side prints first. If you need to rotate the layout, here are some tips. Most layout programs, like Photoshop and Photoshop Elements, allow you to rotate the layout. For example, in Photoshop, go to the Image menu and find the Image Rotate feature. Choose 180 degrees, and the layout will flip like this. If you cannot find a way to rotate the layout in your design software, you can do the job in your printer driver. On a Canon printer, go to the Page Setup tab. Now click the Rotate 180 degree box. Check this box with each print, as it may revert to the default position. With Epson printers, you'll go to the Page Layout tab and click Rotate 180 degrees. Like Canon printers, check this setting with each print to verify it's set correctly. Most printers have a thick paper setting. It may also be called Prevent Paper Abrasion, Prevent Scraping, and on some Epson printers, you will have a Platen Gap control. It's good practice to turn this feature on when you use inkjet note cards. It's a must if you encounter ink smudges. Go to redriverpaper.com/feed for specific help turning on these settings with your printer.